Yeah. Hold the phone. You got coronavirus for 2 weeks and didn't tell me?
I had the Rona.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Okay. Because this is breaking news. Welcome to Come Back with Erica Cobb, a community of folks like yourselves who are getting ready and staying ready for their next chapter. We're thinking of our small business owners right now as we are talking about reopening. We are all affected by this differently, but our small businesses, our entrepreneurs, are some of the hardest hit in the community due to close down. So I wanted to have a conversation with my girlfriend, Amanda Gordon, owner of Gojo Auto. Amanda is here in Denver, and she is, let me just note, the first Black female to have a dealer's license. So what up with that?
Hey, Colorado.
In Colorado, yes, absolutely.
Yep, I'm an independent car dealer here in Colorado. Pre-corona, we were absolutely on an upslope. We were growing about 250% month over month.
Which is incredible.
Which is insane and incredible and so thankful and blessed, and teams working their butts off. And then to instantly see the leads stop coming in, the phones are slowing down, the traffic in our showroom, it was scary. So again, I as the leader of the pack, had to start taking this thing seriously. Luckily, at the beginning of this thing, we were in a financially stable position because we had such a strong first quarter. But again, I'm still a new business, have some debt tied up with startup costs, etc. So, you know, it takes a while before you get even and truly get into the black, into right. positively making income. So, you know, we're still paying some stuff off, but we had a very strong first quarter. So we were in a position where in the beginning, I was not stressed out. I was like, this too shall pass. March 22nd was our very last car deal.
And this is interesting to me because it was a person who was working on the front lines.
Yes, it was, actually.
Yeah.
Yes, it was. It was a nurse. And then we shut our doors. So, I didn't ask to shut my business down for 4 weeks. You know, right. I didn't ask to put my employees on unemployment. It was something that was forced upon us. And so these big companies, or small companies for that matter, that are pivoting and saying, hey, we're going to do the right thing. We're going to lower rates. We're going to push payments out because it's the right thing to do. Gives people hope, and it takes the burden off of their financial strain that they're already going through, because even those that are working right now are still scared day to day.
But talking to you today, I know that someone out there is going to be thinking in terms of hope. Comeback Kids, it's always a pleasure. Go to comeback.tv for more information.